गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट. इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द ग्रुप मोनेरा. इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द प्रोटिस्टा. द प्रोटिस्टा इज कम्स फ्रॉम द ग्रीक वर्ड प्रोटिस्टोस दैट मीन फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल. इट्स मीन दैट कि प्रोटिस्टा आर द फर्स्ट लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स विच हैविंग ए टाइप ऑफ यूकैरियोटिक सेल. मीन्स having nucleus in their cellular structure, double membrane only are there. So first we discuss about the general characters of the protista. They are unicellular eukaryotes, means वो single cell eukaryotic हैं. They found in sea water के अंदर, moist के अंदर, fresh water और sometimes planktons, the small organisms which are eukaryotic. They locomote, means they locomotion proceed out locomotion by with the help of pseudopodia, the false foot, flagella and cilia. By pseudopodia in amoeba, by the help of flagella into dinoflagellates, and with the help of cilia into euglenoids. Next characteristic is that nutrition. They all are photosynthetic, so they show photosynthetic as well as saprobic, halozoic and parasitic mode of nutrition. Means protista have dual nature in the nutrition. Some are autotrophic, some are heterotrophic. Respiration is generally aerobic, but in some cases when the sunlight is not present, so when the oxygen is not present, they convert into anaerobic. Reproduction is of dual mode, asexual and sexual. The asexual modes are binary fission. In binary fission, the body divide into two equal parts. Multiple fission, body divide into multiple parts. Spore formation and budding. In sexual reproduction, there are two types of syngamy, means fusion of the, means fusion of gametes. Conjugation, this method we have also discussed into the previous lecture. The transform of the genetic material with the help of pili in prokaryotes, in monera. Now on the behalf of nutrition, we divide the protista into three groups: photosynthetic group, saprophytic group and parasitic heterotrophic animal like group. So there are five major groups that are further classified into three. The first, charyophytes, commonly known as diatoms, dinoflagellates and the euglenoids are classified under photosynthetic group. The slime molds are saprophytic group and the protozoans are halozoic, parasitic and animal like characteristics. So generally five groups are there: charyophytes, dinoflagellate, euglenoids, slime molds and protozoans. कि जो प्रोटिस्टा है उसको फाइव ग्रुप में क्लासिफाई किया गया है और बाद में उन फाइव ग्रुप्स को अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर न्यूट्रिशन तीन क्लासेस में रखा गया है. फोटोसिंथेसिस में तीन हैं: कैरिसोफाइट्स, डाइनोफ्लैजिलेट एंड यूग्लिनोइड्स. स्लाइम बाउल्स वो सेप्रोफिटिंग है, मीन्स दे डिपेंड ऑन द डिके और डेड मटेरियल फॉर देयर फूड. प्रोटोजोन्स दे बिहेव एनिमल लाइक स्ट्रक्चर लाइक halozoic parasitic mode of nutrition. So we will discuss about the first group, that is charyophytes. The word charyso means golden. This group show golden color appearance, so they are known as charyophytes. The body divided into two half, so it called diatoms. It perform photosynthesis, so it classified under the golden algae. The general characters of the charyophyte is that, first general character is that they are aquatic and moist and terrestrial habitats, means they can be found in aquatic, moist and terrestrial regions. They may be free floating, means they can be free floating type of locomotion on the surface of the water with the help of mucilage that covers surrounding the body and the lightweight lipids. Due to this, the weight is very lighter and they free float on the water surfaces. They form diatomaceous earth, means the body is covered with siliceous shell, means silica ki covering hoti hai body ke charo taraf, deposit into the cell wall, jo cell wall ke saath deposit hoti rehti hai, known as frustal. To the body divided into two halves, body ke jo do half hain unki jo arrangement hai wo soap box like arrangement hai, jaise ek soap box hota hai उस तरह का अरेंजमेंट होता है इसके अंदर. फ्लैजिला एब्सेंट होती है, क्लोरोफिल ए एंड सी प्रेजेंट, एंड अनदर पिगमेंट दैट इज फ्यूकोजेंथिन दैट शो ब्राउन एंड गोल्डन कलर, सो दिस नोन एज गोल्डन एल्गी. द सॉप बॉक्स अरेंजमेंट इज लाइक दैट, वन इज लार्ज हाफ एंड वन इज स्लाइटर small half and the two walls are present. The bigger half is known as epitheca, the smaller half is known as hypotheca, and these two walls are closed or covered by the silica. The body is having two type of symmetry, one is bilateral, means body divided into two equal half, only when it divided into longitudinal. सेंट्रिक रेडियल सिमेट्री, रेडियल सिमेट्री में क्या होता है कि जब हम रेडियल सिमेट्री में हम बॉडी को किसी भी एंगल से कट करेंगे तो इट डिवाइड इनटू टू इक्वल हाफ. आप उसको लॉन्गिट्यूडिनल, ट्रांसवर्स, क्रॉस ट्रांसवर्स कैसे भी कट करेंगे तो वो बॉडी है दो इक्वल पार्ट्स में डिवाइड हो जाती है. तो अकॉर्डिंग टू बायलेटरल इट हैविंग टू टाइप, पिन्नेट टाइप एंड सेंट्रिक टाइप. नेक्स्ट फूड, द फूड विच इज रिजर्व इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ऑयल एंड ल्यूकोसीन, जो एक कार्बोहाइड्रेट की फॉर्म है, इट इज ए चेन ऑफ सैकराइड्स, सो इट इज ए पॉलीसैकराइड, ल्यूकोसीन एंड द ऑयल. रिप्रोडक्शन, रिप्रोडक्शन कॉमन मोड इज बाइनरी फ्यूजन. जनरली द बॉडी डिवाइड इन टू two parts. Here we know that the longer half is, sorry, the larger half is epitheca, smaller half is hypotheca. यहाँ देखो एक large half है एक small. जो cytoplasmic region है becomes double, nucleus double हो जाएंगी, दोनों parts अलग हो जाते हैं. Hypotheca, sorry, it's epitheca and the hypotheca. Now we have two half, one having epitheca, another has hypotheca. So after the division of two half, a new membrane is formed here. Epitheca remains same and the new hypotheca is generated here, and the hypotheca of the parent is act as epitheca and the new hypotheca hypotheca is formed here. So always the hypotheca is newly formed. Vegetative propagation show mitosis, means equivalent division, body divided into two parts, and the genetic material also divided into two parts. So this is the generally mode of asexual reproduction. Now we will discuss about the sexual reproduction into charyophytes. In the sexual reproduction mode, there are two special conditions. The sexual reproduction are different according to their symmetry. It is pinnate bilateral symmetry and the centric radial symmetry. When the symmetry is pinnate, it show conjugation, and when the body's structure is centric, the radial symmetry, it is gametogenesis, means formation of the gametes. Now here we see that this is the two different charisophytes or diatoms having their own nucleus and the epithic and hypothic. Both are conjugated, mixed together, and the cell wall, the epithica and the hypothica, started slowly the degradation. Means जो cell wall है वो धीरे धीरे break होना start हो जाती हैं, and a mucilage cover its cytoplasm. जो cell का cytoplasm है उसके चारों तरफ एक mucilage की covering आ जाती है, and slightly cell wall becomes non-visible. After this condition, the cell wall is absent and the mucilage cover the nucleus. Here the meiosis division occurs. We know in the meiosis division one cell generates four haploid cells. So one nucleus give rise four nucleus and four from another. So here we have total eight haploid nucleus. It is phenomenon that only half is usable and half becomes degenerated. So here this two is from this and the next two from this, and the remaining four are degenerated. Out of eight, कि आठ में से चार degenerate हो जाएंगे, वो जो चार हैं वो मिलकर two diploid cells बनाएंगे, and that known as oxospore. That's known as oxospore. So oxospores are the diploid stage nucleus, and this further develops their hypotheca and epitheca. New cells are formed. In this, the genetic material is transferred from each parents, and finally the sexual reproduction, the transfer of the gametes or transfer of the genetic material take place. Next, that is under the centric structure, the gametogenesis. One act as male and one act as female. The male reproduce gamete, that male gamete that is biflagellate. We have said that the charisophyte do not have flagella, but in special case during the sexual reproduction, the charisophytes have flagella, known as spermatozoa, and the female release egg. The egg and spermatozoa undergo fertilization, the type of oogamous, means where the egg is stationary and the sperm is motile, and they are also having N and N. After fertilization, the formation is also 2N, the oxospore, and the oxospore forms new cell. So this is the type, this is the mode of sexual reproduction in the both. In pinnate symmetry, it is conjugation. In centric symmetry, it is gametogenesis. Example of the charisophytes are Navicula, Cymbella, and Amphiplura. The next point is that what is the economic importance of the diatoms? Diatoms, we are saying that they are first eukaryotic cell, they perform photosynthesis, so they perform the most of the 70-80% photosynthesis, means they are the chief producers of the ocean. They produce high amount of oxygen and consume carbon dioxide. In structure we have studied that कि द टू हाफ आर कवर्ड विद द सिलिका व्हेन द डायटम्स बिकम्स डेड द अनदर पार्ट्स आर डिकम्पोज्ड एंड द सिलिका रिमेन्स एज इट इज रिजल्ट इन टू द फॉर ए लॉन्ग टाइम पीरियड द सिलिका आर डिपोजिटेड ऑन दैट प्लेस कि जो सिलिका है वो उसी जगह पर डिपोजिट होती रहेगी दैट रिजल्ट इन टू द डाई एटोमियस अर्थ कि वहाँ पे एक मिट्टी की परत जमा होती चली जाएगी दैट फॉर्म्स डाई एटोमियस अर्थ एंड दिस डाई एटोमियस अर्थ आर यूज टू फिल्टर द ऑयल्स सिरप्स सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द कैरियोसोफाइट्स Now we will discuss about the next lecture. We will discuss about the second group of the protista that are dinoflagellates.